Hello and welcome back everyone to French Bread's solo Amazon run of Dragon's Crown. No, I have still not thought of a creative name for this series yet.
Go back.
I'm going to have to work on that at some point. But for our purposes, we're going to head straight to turning in that side quest as usual. Beastmaster. Treasure art, the Dark Elf Beastmaster. Pretty spicy. Dark elves are antisocial by nature, even amongst themselves, a trait which ultimately led to their demise at the hands of other races. Surviving dark elves were forced from their lands by other elves, and mostly reside underground. Without a large central population, it's unlikely that future generations will inherit and carry on their customs. However, some individual dark elves still wander the land, using their magic to dominate violent beasts. You have the potential to be a beast tamer, a very powerful skill. Keep your bloodline going so you can spread this power to your descendants. The dark elf tells you before departing, never to be seen again. Are they saying that the person who hired us was actually a dark elf or something? And they were farming for talent? It's a little unclear to me, but there you go. Pretty cool art by Shigatake. And another level, which I ain't gonna complain about. Oops, we don't want to go to the gallery. We want to learn skills. Got 4 skill points, and we are level 9. Let's go about this methodically. Berserk is our core. We definitely want the next level of Berserk. Cannot get adrenaline yet. We cannot improve War Paint yet. So our next skill that we're going to take is going to be Incite Rage. It's another item, which means we're going to lose another equipment slot, but it lets us auto berserk in exchange for a little bit of HP. So it's something we're going to want, ultimately. And then, oops. We don't have any more Amazon skills available that we need or want or any of that, so do more money is power. If I'm honest, I'm starting to doubt whether or not this is actually all that useful, but oh well. And let's get adroit hands to reduce the cooldown time between using items, because we're going to enjoy using items. Alrighty. That's where we're at, so our next point of order is to head to Wallace's underground labyrinth to look for the magician Liu Kang. Liu Kang, Liu Kang. Can barely tell the difference. Here we go.
This underground labyrinth is said to have been made in a single night with powerful magic. It is a dangerous place replete with traps. It bars entry to all who would dare.
As you can hear, we've switched our narrator to the Amazon, which is slightly weird since we are now narrating ourselves, but hey, what you gonna do? Man, these wooden golems have quite a bit of poise, do they not? Alright, they also have very strong tells, so we can just back off for just a moment, let them do their attack, and then get right back in there to mess them up.
I got it!
Oh yeah!
It would appear that Wallace's workshop is lousy with villainous sorcerers, we'll call them.
Simple.
trap so sprung, we get a bit of treasure
and the door
here.
Magically closed fast.
But as you can see,
slime creatures are weak against fire.
It's also a trap.
The torch on the wall could be used to great effect.
Yes, thanks me. I already noticed. Get our berserk even
the
from simply
hitting the ground can be heard.
Flaming slimes. Where's the key? There it is.
Obtain a magic key to open the door.
We're gonna go ahead and pick that up. Use it. There we go. So that we can get out of this endless slime trap. Eat up some of our food and get back into the fray. Wizards are slightly annoying, but predictably. Tommy. I assume it's Tommy. Could be. Whoops. Could be any old punk thief. He's got a remarkable amount of insistence. Stubborn. Gotta take him down at least 3 times before he learns his lesson. I'm thinking that's Tommy. I suppose it could just be generic thief, but
yes.
Either way, you can't have what's rightfully ours. By right of might, anyway.
Out of the blue, a mouse darts out and leaps onto your palm. The rodent claims to be the apprentice of Wallace the Magician. He says he was tasked with caring for the laboratory while Wallace was gone, but it is beset by malevolent magic users. When you ask about Lucane, the apprentice answers that his master's friend went into the labyrinth and hasn't returned. Your quest to find Lucane is delayed as you attempt to liberate the lab for Ricky, the magician's apprentice.
The names are just so delightfully mundane in this game. Ricky.
The door to the laboratory is through this hall.
Let's see if we can get that chest open before the enemies show up.
Simple.
Well done, except for it's an E rank, making it quite useless.
Yes.
One and all. It's interesting to me that Ranny levels up. What is he gaining? He doesn't really seem to be picking locks anymore. Oh. You boarded to the wrong location, my friend. You open that.
It's my turn.
Oh yeah.
I'll finish scanning the area. Okay, so here we have a floor. Oh shit, I accidentally ran forward. Ah, crap. Oh, we had to do this anyway. Ah, bastard hit me. I think eventually there's a skill that lets us not lose our rage immediately. Alright, so if I remember, the combination is some sort of like, yep, there we go. A zigzag maneuver.
Oh, yes. Done.
Not super interested in crossbows, so we're gonna let that lie. But you've been noticing all the runes on the wall. If you haven't played this game, they do serve a function, but not one that we have access to as of yet.
There's been a population explosion of mutated beings that spread their spores around. The labyrinth is overrun by fungi.
Theoretically, get a lot of potential experience here. There we go. Use the fire to, I guess for one, you can mess up. Whoa, paralyzing. Paralyzing agent. For one, you can mess up these myclinoids. Myclinoids? I think that's how you pronounce it. Gotta be honest, that's one of those terms that I often see in fantasy, but I haven't really ever heard aloud. So I could be the fool here. Either way, they are not too big of a threat, all things considered, and they are violently weak to fire. Go. I guess the only real... Oops. Listen to me talking, and I just lost a life point. Talking shit. When your HP drops to zero, you can fight no longer. You recover automatically using one life point to revive. Jesus Christ. Talking shit, not paying attention to my own life. And I get messed up. But my main point was going to be that if you don't take care of these guys in short order, they have the potential to do what this guy is doing over here and grow into a larger form, which actually is dangerous, as opposed to the smaller ones, which are mostly just a nuisance. Man, I can't believe we got killed there. It's our first life point in the entire playthrough so far, and we got wrecked by mushrooms, of all things. Bodes ill for our future exploits. These things are incredibly foul in their own right. You want to stay away from them as they die, because they will, well, you can see it's already hit me. They will emit a bit of poison as they expire. Crap, I need to be, okay, need to be slightly higher. Did destroy this beehive, wasp hive I should say. Where's a honey buzzard when you need it? Looks like just being near these guys can cause me poison issues when they have those disgusting tentacle things out. Ugh. I've randomly picked that. See if I can one-shot this thing. Yep.
Done.
That's not a bad treasure reward. Reward? That's what I just said. Plumber's dream.
What?
Very nice touch with the larger mushrooms. Just giving that little bit of elastic give as you hit them. Shame on Ranny, though, for freaking getting in my way. Look at this bastard just going to the ends of the earth. One complaint I have with the Amazon is that her jumping, rolling, spinning thing is, you know, it's fairly useful. But it doesn't do as much damage as just being on the ground and hitting, and it's very easy to overshoot when that happens. Can't change my equipment. I forgot to equip Insight Rage. That's fine. I think we'll be good with just our War Paint and our Strength Drought. Because we've just reached the boss. Oops. See what I... It's... You dodge out of the way, which is great, fine, whatever, but takes. Blah. Okay. Do want to fuck. Isn't usually use that attack so frequently. We really want to destroy that fucking cocoon. God, I am not having a good fight this time. We really want to destroy these cocoons because they're just going to birth more Doom Beetles, and more Doom Beetles is kind of a problem for us. You can also see why we like our uses of adroit hands, just so we can get back to using our items as quick as possible. I really just gotta like let not start attacking too soon after dodging, just because of how far I'm going to overshoot and probably just end up right back in front of the enemy if I don't watch it. It feels like lost damage, but at the end of the day, not getting hit is far superior to any alternative available to us. Alright, as you can see, I kind of picked up my quality of play there.
You found some bones that seemed to belong to Lucane in the depths of the labyrinth. The tattered raiments and jewelry leave no doubt that the corpse is indeed Lucane's.
Alright, so we got a bunch of B-rank treasures. That's not terrible.
You bring back the bones of the
magician. Did we come just, yeah, we came just shy of a level. That kind of sucks. Alright. Let's appraise these weapons at our disposal. I don't like that they're all single digit, though. That's not very helpful. Those are E. Don't care. Okay, so counter with lightning, 18% chance. That's not super amazing. Nah, that's not amazing. That's not amazing. I don't think I want any of these. So, it's payday. Pure payday. And actually, we're doing so good on time.
But he was dead.
That I think it's going to be a double feature. Overcome with grief.
When you enter the laboratory, the fairy frantically flits around you, as if it senses your uneasiness. Upon seeing Lucane's bones, the fairy enters into a panic. She begins tugging at your arm to get you to leave the tower.
Yeah, to the instant resurrection church.
The fairy is apparently attempting to lead you somewhere. You collect
the terrifying resurrection church.
As you enter, a kindly voice echoes from the back. You seem to be in need of help, a monk says, and approaches
you. Yeah, monk, everybody in the world needs help.
You nervously hand the monk the bones of Lucane.
When you can revive the dead, everyone needs your help.
Allow this heart to beat again.
I suppose if it revives the dead in the state they were
the prayer reaches the gods
at the time of their death, as it certainly seems to do with Lucane,
once again given. Lucane, shocked to find himself
then
alive,
you can't beat profusely. Death by
he tells
aging
you to visit
at any
him
rate
at his laboratory and leaves.
But come on, that's like
the resurrected magician has returned
best
to the old tower in town.
Those dying by age is half of the deaths we encounter, especially in this sort of fantasy world. I imagine many people do not live to enjoy old age and die that way.
The magician Lucane is waiting for you in the laboratory of the old tower.
He has the gnarliest hands.
It seems the dying had an adverse effect on his short-term memory. Lucane can't remember why he went to meet Wallace. Lucane is researching magic called runes.
Here's our first rune reference.
To spirits and fairies. Lucane introduces his fairy friend to you. Her name is Tiki. She left the fairy forest due to her strong curiosity. He thanks you again for saving him and allowing him to enjoy life's rich pageant. He displays his magic trinkets. Lucane says that he'd be happy to sell you these items at a fraction of the normal price and answer any questions you have.
Sure.
What will you ask?
Let's ask about Wallace.
The magician Wallace was an old friend of Lucane's. He was known as a great magician. He sealed that group, or myopia, of cyclopes in a labyrinth and saved the land. He also mentored young magicians in his tower. He was also the king's trusted advisor. And Lucane trails off. It seems that Lucane's memory has failed him again. Before you realize it, Tiki is following you around. She seems to have taken a liking to you. She will accompany you on your adventures henceforth. Fairies are known to be adept at finding hidden things.
Alrighty. So, what we're gonna do here is... Well, I guess we'll go to the Adventurers Guild first. And see if there's anything for them to say.
A letter from the castle has come to you via the guild.
Okay. They want us to go to the castle. We don't care. We're going to check out this new quest. Delicacy delivery. The flesh of the giant walking fungi, myconids, is a legendary delicacy among gourmands. However, myconids are also legendarily toxic. The lethal poison that they produce means that only a small portion of their bodies can be rendered safe for consumption. A little bit like a fugu, right? To balance the rampant demand for myconid flesh with safety concerns, a group of scholars would like to research how to cull these creatures in a manner that would provide the largest yield. They request that someone gather myconid spores from Wallace's underground laboratory. Labyrinth. I had to say laboratory, but I guess it's labyrinth. Very well, we'll accept this quest. What we're going to do is have a quick cut. I'm going to do the quest. We'll be back. We'll check out the quest. And then we'll see about doing the next story quest. Alright guys, see you then. Alright you guys, we are back from our side quest. Let's turn that in, first and foremost. Delicacy delivery. Very detailed artwork right here. Fungi researchers, or fungi, if you prefer. The fungi incubation experiment was held in an environment protected from the effects of magic by tripling the normal amount of sacred barriers. The fungi did not grow like the myclinids, but neither did they grow to be poisonous. At the same time, it was discovered that the taste of the non-poisonous fungi is quite terrible. While these results disappointed the gourmands, the researchers didn't seem to be deterred. They will continue their fungus research regardless. Looks like we got researchers of all ages going on here. Hopefully not to the point of child labor. But either way, very nice artwork by Emika Kida. And a very nice level up for us. Let's see what we've won, shall we? I think eventually we're going to have to get some of these abilities that we really don't want. But in the meantime, we just got access to a couple of new good skills. Okay, we're level 11. Deadly Revolution is pretty good. Brutal Drive, when did that become available? Has it always been available? I don't know. Punisher is also very good. Going to select Punisher. I do think we will select Deadly Revolution as well. I think those are both choice Amazon skills, if I recall right. And as for our passives, nothing more to do with Wealth to Health or any of that. I think we're just going to hold on to our skill point. Alright, let's go to the freaking castle.
Count Dean is waiting for you at the throne room. It is he who sent the letter. After your previous encounter, you can only assume that he's up to something nefarious. You brace for combat. The guards have drawn their swords and are blocking the exit. Count Dean starts talking to you in a soft voice. He says that he has personally requested your assistance in performing a task for him. He wants you to scout Bilboran Fortress on the border. This underground fortress is a well-known structure, originally built to defend against the Orc army. It now lies in Orc hands. Scout them and learn their invasion routes. It is a very dangerous mission. But refusal means that you will be at the mercy of Dean's guards. You accept.
So now we're getting strong-armed per Count Dean's request.
You agreed to infiltrate and surveil the subterranean fortress at the country's border.
Very well. Sucks to get pushed around by somebody, but on the same token, can't say no to taking out a few dozen orcs, can we? Well, probably more than a few dozen.
The orc army
by the end of it.
Controls Bilboran, the underground fortress built into the canyon. The king's army has been mounting a fierce offensive to try and reclaim the fortress.
Very cool background for this particular area. So knocking over these coals can actually do a bit of damage. I like the pillars in the ancient ruins. By the way, I think you're noticing now that we are starting to starting to activate our berserk a lot quicker. Ah, apparently that was enough for him.
Yes.
Good.
Done.
Garbage treasure. Bad. You'd think we'd be getting better treasure because we're fighting solo,
you step
but
into the enemy kitchen.
Holy
a
shit.
Chef grabs a goblin instead of meat and suddenly stops. The cook, sensing your presence, stares directly at you. Luckily, her sight's not so keen, so she doesn't notice you. Eventually, the chef returns to her meat cutting. You use the goblin's screams to mask your escape.
Holy shit. Like a completely pointless side diversion, but I guess we got to see some rather fun art. Feel a little bad for that goblin, though. Crossbow dudes must die. By the way, Deadly Revolution should help us maintain a little bit more aerial control. The ticket is once you're spinning one way, you can just spin right the other.
What?
Now, these little bastards are indeed bastards, but get back here, you scumbag. Going for the crossbow. We want to take care of these spike walls because you do take damage purely by touching them. Ranny, could you please? Do believe I gave you an order.
Simple.
There we go. Two birds with one stone there. Enemy is superior. Retreat. That's some defeatist language right there.
Enemies.
Oh, lightning bolts, eh? And poison. Me, oh my. And it even got me. That sucks. Oh well. Randy, if you wouldn't mind, let it not be trapped. A rank. That's what I'm talking about. The treasure is gone, but you know what? Fuck this Tomet guy. Can't abide him. Nice. Lots of podunk treasure to pick up here. It's interesting that bones respawn simply by changing, oops. That's what happens if you jump into one of those spike walls. But it's interesting how bones respawn just by changing screens. I guess they want you to have every opportunity to be able to build an NPC party if you need it. And you so rarely, now that I think about it, you so rarely get any items for burying people that I don't think it's actually unbalanced anyway. So, forget I said anything about it. What are these guys dancing around for? These are Dynasty Warriors. You better attack if you want to survive. Though, if you don't, I don't have any quibbles with that either. Alright, Ranny, get in there. Yes. Here we get an opportunity, I suppose. Oops. To ride the dinosaur. Except we've murdered the dinosaur. It is extremely easy for me to accidentally kill that thing. Oh well. We didn't really want to ride it anyway. See, some of the barrels on the ground here are like dropping out fluid. some of them are, sometimes it's going to be water, which is useful for putting out fires. Sometimes it's going to be oil, which is useful for making fires a bigger deal. The more Punisher we get, it feels like the faster we attack. Not sure if that's Punisher or just extra levels of Berserk that increase our speed. A little bit of treasure. I think Berserk only increases our movement speed and our attack. I don't think it increases the attack speed, but what do I know? Definitely took some damage. Granny, if you don't mind. I think the white barrels are the water and the darker barrels are the fire. You can use this to your advantage if you so desire. I wonder if one of my... Did I accidentally rhyme, first of all? I wonder if my explosive... Yep, that'll light the fire, so... That's actually a little bit more convenient for me. Not being a caster or having a caster in my party. Gives me an option for that. Don't know why we're being coy. Let's just get this part started. Certainly these bones aren't referring to me, are they?
Yes.
You know the drill, Ranny, my friend. Extending. Once your score reaches a certain amount, you will gain one life point. Life points are shown. Yep, LP. Awesome. So we scored well enough to get ourselves an extra life point. Not gonna complain. I was banding about the idea of, you know, that whole one credit sort of idea that if we, see, I like that. If we were to ever to expend, wow, that does not do enough damage for me to care. If we were to ever expend all our life points, that would be game over. I don't think I'm going to do that. I mean, unless I stand in my own fire, I'm not too worried about it, but same token, I'm not too concerned that we're going to suck that bad. I mean, I don't want to sell myself short. I might be able to suck that bad, but ideally, we'll never have to worry about that particular concern. Bats. this situation looks suspicious to you. All the darkness and oil and all that other stuff going around. Well, very good reason looks suspicious to you. This fire is spreading regardless of what we do. Probably the result of goblins being assholes. We will stand in that flame. It means getting some more treasure. Better yet. Ah, shit. This is a problem.
Oh, quit it.
Oh, I can do that. This one is water, so good there. Shit. Would rather not die by flame. Well, I think we're going to lose ourselves a life point. In all likelihood.
At the bottom of the stairs is an
oh no, we've reached the boss room, so we'll have this some food to get us a little bit ahead. Not much food, though. Yeah. I get the strong impression that we're going to get hit at least once and that it's going to kill us immediately. Ah, well. We're still going to fight the boss. Drink our strength draught. Use our war paint. Get on in here. Dodge. Chase after. Oh, apparently we cannot go any farther than that. Good to know. Strength drop is worn out. Oh, shit. Off-screen shenanigans. Well, that's what life points are for, are they not? Get out of his way here. See how Deadly Revolution actually gives me a lot more control when I'm dodging. Ah, shit. We got slightly caught in that. Yep, we can combine our war paint with our power smash to knock this guy right the fuck out. And a little bit of flourish at the end. Axe through the chest.
The reconnaissance mission went well. You gathered intel and slipped back across enemy lines.
What a crap treasure dispersal, though. Oh, well. We got a level.
Among
so.
The treasures you claim is the great sword of the hero Javelin.
Javelin. Ooh, well, if anything was gonna be A rank, I'm glad it was this. Holy shit. Holy shit. 8% chance of enemy jewel drop per attack. Power smash damage plus 15. Damage dealt plus 8. Stun chance plus 12. Holy goddamn. That is a really good weapon. All these other weapons can screw off. Damn, that's incredibly good. Oh, that doesn't even have any ability on it. We don't need the rest of the shit. Holy shit, that's a good axe. I am glad we picked that up. But that said,
you succeeded in acquiring intel on the underground fortress. This job will be completed once you report to Count Dean.
Right. Job will be complete soon. But that said, we have basically gone nearly double time. So I think now is a good time for us to cut it off. I'll experiment around with this format. I kind of want this particular series not to really go over half an hour if we can help it. More of a bite-sized series. You don't want to go too short either. Bit of a predicament. I suppose if I record me doing the side quest, I'd probably more reliably end up around 30 minutes. Not sure how I'll do this yet. Maybe I'll do 2 episodes a week if one episode is too short. That doesn't sound bad. But until next time, guys, hope you enjoyed the Amazon solo run / challenge. Next time we'll be turning this in, and as always, we will complete our new side quests off screen. So, see you then.